This part is a little hard to see where the...
The lines are, right?
Where the lines are.
Line, one, one's here.
Well, just where the smooth is, measure from where the smooth is, Ryan, just measure maybe about 2 or 3 inches wider than where the smooth is. Grab this inside of the field we did.
So here?
Yeah, right.
Pull the subway down to the top very well. And then at the top, roll it over. Roll it over and open up the hand so that the water is all the way to the back of the fingers. Open it up so that it's hard to take that down. Now, try to get the elbows as close to your front. All right, now in that position, right, get your legs a little bit wider. Okay, with the elbows closer in than your hands. Your hands are wider out than your elbows.
Okay.
See if you can go down to pretty darn low. See if you can get front squat. Keep the bar to touch your chest. If your chest is in the hole of the bar, you can go right up. Yeah, and raise yourself. You want the chest to hold it, not to go to the hole. Okay, now go down and squat. So do a few more things. That's a little bit too much opening of the leg. Try to keep them a little bit more pointed over the head. Even a little bit closer, so you'll hear more. But you don't have to open them up with much. And again, the trick is to keep these things up. You're going to learn this. Come down, come down. Try to get the elbows in and have a way back. Oh, yeah. When you're parallel to the ground. Five, then the hips are parallel to the ground. See how nice. Yeah, most people can't get their hands up. A little bit. A little bit. A little bit. A little bit.
I feel good. Yeah.
Once you get this, then you must be the thing.
Yeah. You're just like the flexibility.
And you
something
like crazy.
Yeah, five meals.
And then after about a month, you're going to say,
I felt it in my back. Once I erected
it. It's easy on you, but you're not going to hurt yourself with every back squat.
Yeah.
The problem with the back squats is that you know, they don't really have another additional benefit. With this, once you learn this, you can power clean most of your work.
Yeah.
One
becomes easier. Yeah.
Clean is number one, front squats, or back squats, but in this case, front squats just as good. And one is the bench is way down at the bottom of the list.
Yeah, true.
Okay,
I was benching first, like in high school.
What's that?
I was benching first in high school.
Yeah.
I guess I did it backwards.
Yes. All right, do another one for me. And remember, let him roll all the way down at the core.
And then
try to do this. You see, your hands, look how much wider they are than your arms. There's your elbow in your hand. A lot of people can't do that. You're not going to get some 330-pound bite. A short arm and a 70-inch chest. How's he going to do it?
Sure.
The coach is going to give him the
old... This is like the size right here.
Yeah. The coach is going to give him the entire mind of the title for the new set.
Forget
about it. Forget about it.
Pretty much.
He said, just forget about it, son. I know you're trying. Forget about it. You try to get them close. But then it's easier on your hand. This will transfer to front to your opponents. That's why this... Thousands of those kids, boys and girls, after school, after my teaching, they use a cooking degree. This one was the one I think kind of put the most. Whether it's hitting a baseball, wrestling, football, basketball, you name it, it transfers to everything. That is the number one lift in college sports coaches put on the boards all over the strength and conditioning centers that are huge. Who has the highest power to get in the events?
Okay.
All right,
cool.
Tell me the
not like a lot of weight. My knee is still bothering me, so I can do, at most I can do 25 on it.
But that's fine, but you don't have to do that much. For a week or two, just put on a pad on your side, set it apart. It has nothing to do
So I'm used to it. It feels good though. I feel it like all in my body.
I have kids in my room. I used to be from the left. I don't need to sound like I'm bragging. I used to have a kid that was school. I teach a week to do this. I wasn't coaching the school. I wasn't coaching the school. I wasn't coaching the school. We got out at 1:35. The time was at rest at 2 o'clock. And some girls and girls in there. I was like a football player. I never had all the way to 6 o'clock. This season, that season, I never had to teach the kids.
Awesome.
But we had it. We had machines to do a little minor stuff. But we had 15 Olympic sets.
Wow.
And it was an even number. 5 squat racks, and then across. 5 clean areas, which was like a box. Just like a box. And 5 bench. And then all the little supplementary exercises of machines. But the big area had an even number of cleans. The squats, the bench, because otherwise, I didn't know how many people could.
Right.
So I did a 1 week orientation before everything started. So when they got to my room, they would put those 15 bars out there for me to teach my squats and the cleans.
And then once I got the fundamentals down, it was easy to do.
I did it for almost 40 years. All right, here we go, buddy. All right, now grab this, and you grab it last time before you're. Why is he on his bar?
Yeah.
It's going to be like new bar. It's the same way. Okay, now, Ryan, here's what I want you to do, my friend. See if you can do this. Get your feet. That's where you have it before. Not too wide. Too wide at all. Maybe even a little narrower than the squats. And just sticking your butt out. The first thing is stick that butt out and see if you can bring the bar down so the back is nice and flat so it's right on top of the bar and above the kneecap.
So here.
Yeah. But yeah, you gotta get like that linebacker look. You have to really stick that butt out like you just can't. Just let them hang in the Don't jump them over. Just hang with them. You just barely touch it. You can actually sit on it as much. Do a couple of things. Just go to starting position. And just practice the dip. A little slow. And lean forward a little bit. Yeah. Get the chest in the way. Do a couple more. And that's the hard part to get first.
Just
one more. Alright, now put the bar at the end of the hand.
Probably. It'd be a lot better.
Oh, right. Okay. Now we're going to teach you a little movement. It's slow, the best. That's why it's such a valuable lift for what men have been asking. All right, this time, buddy. Make believe. Okay, here's what I'm going to show you what I want you to do. You got to go down real slow. And then, boom! And then, boom! I mean, just really clocked.
Like powered up.
Yeah, watch again. I'm sticking my butt out. And keeping my back flat. As soon as I get right to the top of the kneecap, right here, without pausing, get up on my toes, and elbows in, and hands out, just like you did for the flat squat.
So I'm standing on my toes on this?
Oh, yeah, okay. Definitely. You're not leaving the floor, but you're popping up on your toes.
Okay.
You want to watch my feet again?
Okay.
And then, you're going to hear it.
Right.
All right. Don't worry. I don't expect you to do it perfect. It's going to take a little time. But once you learn how to do it, then you're going to be cool.
Yep.
Okay, my friend. Real slow. Put your feet a little bit closer together. For this, you'd be a little closer together.